Right, not how we expected to start today's video, but we found vending machine heaven. So we've got biscuits and noodles and Oreo bits. Got cup noodle machine. We've got an ice cream machine, including the ice cream and a carton. We've got a selection of drinks. Got teas, maybe? Coffees? More drinks, and then a beer vending machine, which we've already had from before upstairs, like as a mix, but oof, oh wait, that didn't focus. There we go. Don't want you to miss out on the beer. You've just seen the vending machine to start the day. It is currently 20:02. We've had a bit of a late start. Why have we had a late start?
Because I'm
falling to bits. Avon's falling to bits. Avon's been warned that she might not be allowed to go on holiday again if she doesn't start to behave herself. Now, you have had a bit of a rough time this week between being sick on the plane.
Yep, sick on the plane.
Conjunctivitis. The heat rash and the swelling.
Heat rash and mosquitoes love me, but I do not love mosquitoes.
So we had to go to the doctors today, because yesterday at Universal, we kind of powered through the day, but we were like worried that Yvonne had an infection or might have to go to the doctors. So we ended up this morning, we phoned the insurance company and end up getting it. Basically, the long and short is, we went down to the concierge, who were amazing. They set us up with a doctor, which was like a 5-minute walk around the corner from us, who also spoke English. She was super.
She's brilliant.
And basically, Yvonne had some massive blisters on her legs where she had some bites and a really bad rash. So they've given you steroid cream
and tablets.
Yeah, so.
But look at the neck of my legs.
Yeah, let me show you this. The other thing it says is that you don't have any infection, which was the main thing.
Yes, that was the main thing.
So, yeah, Yvonne's legs, I mean, they're all covered up just now, but you can see some of the rash that goes with it. I kind of wish we had now.
I've got a photo.
Oh, Yvonne's got a photo of the blister, so insert a photo here. But yeah, she's been gauzed up. This is why she's not allowed to get her. Look at the fucking state of that. I just swore. I have one blister, but now that I've on her steroid cream, I'm alright.
Glad that it isn't infected. Like, I was pretty sure it was now, but we wanted to just make sure, because didn't want to get further into the holiday and then
it ended up being worse. Yeah. Aye. So yeah, we kind of left Universal abruptly yesterday because, one, there was this crack of thunder that just, like, we both jumped because it was mega loud and we're like, we didn't want to be here when it starts pouring. And we'd done everything we wanted to, but the other thing we'd decided is time to come home and just relax and get the feet up, try and bring the swelling down, which had helped because your leg looked a lot better this morning. So we're just going to go explore Kyoto. We're going to split tomorrow because we're meant to be in Hiroshima today. So we're a bit sad about missing that, but it was for the best. So we're going to split our Kyoto day and do today and tomorrow over 2 days to just kind of keep the mileage down.
Yes.
So let's go. But now we have a melon pan, which we'll be excited to try. So, Yvonne is taking photos. This is all that's left there. It has like a melony cream in it, and it is phenomenal.
And it's cantaloupe.
Oh, cantaloupe. Yep, absolutely.
It tastes like that.
Would absolutely get that again. Right, we're out. venture into, that's the station. And we're just making our way around Kyoto. Oh, Japan. It's just a random shrine. We think this might be the what we saw in Tokyo, like the same idea that they were talking about. Oh, hang on. This float parades through the area on occasion of festival Okonomiyaki Shrine. The original float's been left unattended for a long time, but enthusiastic will be able to restore it. The ornaments of the float are historic and are designated as tangible folklore assets by Kyoto. So yeah, it must be the same as like the thing that we saw them. Aye, a festival in Tokyo. It's like the Tokyo Fair Day. A wee modded high-jet cargo, look at the exhaust on it. Look, it's also got the subway ring on the bottom. The adventure continues. Across this on the train.
That could be.
So got to the gear on this train, and the first place we come across is a little temple where it's like a little bridge over a water garden. It's pretty cool, and as usual, some big fish. And up this way to the temple. We're continuing to make our way up the hill, but in the distance you can see the temple just poking out. We've made it to the bottom of the Gion district, I think, and look, we've hit the Ghibli shop. Also, I just spotted the scarecrow. It's a very, very cool shot. Outside and inside. Bring your big blankets as well. So, all the way up there is the temple, which we are heading towards. What a view. So, this is what we're greeted with at the very top. It looks phenomenal. We're obviously keep going up, but wow. The guards at the entrance. Honestly, amazing. Amazing. So we've got the top of the stairs and look at that. Also we're gonna go over for a closer look, but wow. Now I'm assuming that could be the protector of the temple, but it is absolutely incredible. So, that's a view out to Kyoto, and that's the view
where we came. It is incredible. Absolutely beautiful. And there is the temple. I don't know how this comes up on camera, but it's like it's got a tiger carved in it. So, another place to make your wishes. And it was right. So hard to get a shot at because of the light. So we're going in to the temple, isn't this? A temple we're at today. Incredible.
So I did the fortune and it was all bad, so I'm going to tie that on there
because otherwise I'm going to be in a long lawsuit. What else was it? Bad health.
The renovations will go badly.
Renovations will go badly, so yeah, I'm going to tie it on. So, fortune deposited. All my bad luck's gone. And now we're here. And by the way, I'm not looking at Avon as my bad luck. I'm just hoping that Avon's bad luck also ends with my fortune. So, yeah, we came across here. And again, what a spectacular view. There's a view impact proper on the left, but it's so busy, it's just perfect.
Yeah,
the temple. These are some steep stairs. And that's what the temple's built on. Look at that, that's mad. And now up the other side. The wildlife has gone mad. Let's see what happened now. All this way, fancy. If we go down the hill. A cheeky three-story number. You just keep going to different parts of this temple. It's beautiful. There it is up there behind us, that's where we started. Earlier on, you can't see the other one. Tonight's Okonomiyaki. Here it is. I went for pork with cheese added, and I went for beef. We wait 4 or 5 minutes here, maybe close to an hour or so. I hope it's good. Find out what
I'm
as has been the case with a couple of videos lately, I forgot to film on the day an outro, which I think is fair enough given that was the day that we had the doctor, so it was a bit of a mad day, and we were a bit obviously concerned trying to get everything sorted out. But as I said on the day in the video, it was so easy. Like, our hotel were absolutely great. The concierge phoned the doctor for us, translated everything. Then when we went, the doctor was really helpful, absolutely amazing. So it all worked out well in the end, which was obviously the main thing. And then it didn't really have any impact beyond that on the rest of the holiday. But what I would say is, you know, about the day, we went to Kyomizu-dera temple. It took me 4 attempts to say it. So Kyomizu-dera temple was amazing, obviously set up on the hill, and the views were absolutely stunning. This was something we had in the plan to do anyway, so it just kind of made that we took Kyoto, we had the extra day, we used it, spent a bit of time, kind of paced ourselves a wee more in Kyoto and saw a bit more of Kyoto than we probably would have, so it worked out really well in that sense. Obviously a bit sad that we never got to go to Hiroshima, but it was kind of one of those things where we just had to make the right decision for us, which this was. And then obviously we had our Okonomiyaki at night, which was phenomenal. Food in Japan is just amazing in general, and I don't think we ate anything that we didn't enjoy. So yeah, it was absolutely great, and great to spend a bit extra time in Kyoto, and obviously that everything worked out fine in terms of the bites that Yvonne had picked up. So yes, I hope you enjoyed the video, and the next one will be the final day in Kyoto, so I'll see you for that. Bye.